Hello everyone, my name is Michel Lourd. I've been an underwater archaeologist for 42 years, and for the last 15 years, I was running France's Underwater Archaeology Research Department, or DRASP for short. My 40 years of experience have taught me that the remains of underwater cultural heritage that humanity has consigned over centuries to the bottom of the sea are facing the gravest of dangers. Indeed, if the sea is the largest museum in the world, it's also, unfortunately, the only museum for which today there is no reliable protection. In addition to the effects of climate change, which we have observed over the last few decades, the sunken repository of culture is also suffering the ravages of incessant economic and industrial activity, of frequent looting, of concessions granted to merciless commercial operations, of trawl nets churning up the seabed, and more. In such circumstances, we cannot expect it to survive indefinitely. Consequently, it's our responsibility, both individual and collective, to ensure its protection, to analyze the lessons it teaches us, and to guarantee its conservation. Since 2001, UNESCO has offered its member states the opportunity to adopt the Convention on the Protection of Underwater Cultural Heritage. To date, more than 70 states have ratified this convention. A large number indeed, but not enough. In fact, almost every state in the world has a coastline, a river, or a lake that has played a very important role in their development throughout history. It was by water that most contacts were made between civilization and distant peoples. It was also by water that economic, cultural, and religious exchanges were established and that human trafficking was once carried out. As a result, submerged artifacts can reveal a particular page in the history of shipping, an example of trade, an overview of technological progress at a given point in time, or perhaps reveal intimate insights into cultural and religious practices. This is why it now comes down to the countries that have not yet done so to ratify the UNESCO 2001 Convention and for all of us to apply it in the waters under our jurisdiction to establish a universal safety net for underwater cultural heritage.